Hello students, today we will study about the corrosion of metals. Let us first know the meaning of the word corrosion. Corrosion means breaking of a substance or destruction of a substance. So corrosion of metal means the destruction of metals. It is a process in which metals are eaten up by the action of air, moisture or a chemical such as an acid. Let us study about the corrosion of metals with the help of some examples. First of all, we will study about the corrosion of iron. Now the corrosion of iron is called rusting. What is rust? It is a reddish brown flaky substance which covers the iron objects. When left in damp air, what is the meaning of the word damp? Damp means air containing moisture. See, the rust makes the iron objects very weak. So, the rusting should be prevented. Rust is basically hydrated iron 3 oxide. So its formula would be Fe2O3.xH2O. What is the meaning of X here? X means there can be any number of water molecules. Now for prevention of the rusting of iron, the iron objects can be painted or oil can be applied on their surface. Another method for preventing the rusting of iron can be galvanization. What is the meaning of galvanization? See, galvanization means to coat the iron objects with zinc metal by the process of electrolysis. Or the iron objects can be alloyed with chromium or nickel or other metals so that the rusting of iron can be prevented. The basic idea is to cut off the connection between iron and air. Now let us study about the corrosion of aluminium metal. See, unlike iron metal, the corrosion of aluminium metal is useful. How? We know that the aluminium is more reactive metal than iron. You must have studied the reactivity series of metal. Still, it is used to make utensils. Why? Because a very thin layer of aluminium oxide is formed on the surface of aluminium objects, which protect them from further corrosion. So this is how the corrosion of aluminium metal is useful, whereas the corrosion of iron metal was destructive. Why? Because it was making the iron objects weak. Now the layer of aluminium oxide on the surface of aluminium objects can be made thicker by the process of electrolysis. This process is called anodizing. This process will help the aluminium objects to prevent their further corrosion, and these objects will be protected. Now let us study about the process of corrosion of copper metal. See, the process of corrosion of copper metal is different from the corrosion of iron and aluminium. As the process of corrosion of iron and aluminium is mainly because of oxygen. But in the case of copper metal, the corrosion of copper metal occurs due to the action of carbon dioxide and water present in the air. So, a green coating of a mixture of copper carbonate and copper hydroxide is formed on the copper metal, which corrodes it. Let us take one more metal, that is silver. The corrosion of silver metal is also different. Why? Because it is because of the action of hydrogen sulfide gas. So, the silver objects gradually tarnish. Tarnish means turns black due to the formation of a thin layer of silver sulfide on their surface. This layer is formed by the action of hydrogen sulfide gas present in the air. So this is how different metals are corroded by the action of different materials present in air. You should also know that gold and platinum, being least reactive metals, do not corrode easily even after several years of use. And so, gold and platinum metals are used to make jewelry.